This was a great documentary. So many things to talk about. First, I'll talk about the connection between journalism, anthropology, and voyeurism, where basically you see it's the same fundamental drive at the heart of all of them. The only difference is standards and ethics that make journalism and anthropology sciences and respected, and voyeurism a borderline crime. You see the journalist and the voyeur sharing this desire to see all the aspects of humanity, especially maybe the ugliest aspects, and then document and collect it. You see the voyeur with this collection of stamps and other things, and then you compare it to the journalist and his office of meticulously keeping track of all these interactions he's had over the years. And what was interesting was how poorly this journalist, Gay Talese, came off. For him to come off as a bigger creep than this guy who spent 15 years spying on people without their consent was really something. It seemed like he had spent so long in this bubble of New York and investigative reporting that he'd lost any ability to have just a basic human reaction to things. When his source talks about feeling betrayed by the stuff he included in his article, rather than showing 1 ounce of compassion or humanity, he just launches into this speech about journalistic principles. And then when he goes, "These guys aren't even credible journalists, they're just cameramen," you get the sense that he feels because he was born from money and went to fancy journalism schools, he has this kind of moral authority, when on the contrary, it seems that his moral compass is completely broken. And the stuff that at the start of the documentary seemed kind of endearing, him taking a pride in his appearance and clothes, at the end just seemed like him being an elitist prick. And not only does he come across as kind of a shitty guy, he comes across as a shitty journalist. He seems to write this article, not fact check it, and then when someone does fact check it, he panics, disavows the article, doesn't fact check the fact check, and then later realizes the fact check was flawed and has to backtrack again. And then Gerald, it's interesting, obviously seems like a bad guy, but it seems like the documentary does a lot to humanize him. You get an insight into how his mind works when he says, "Neighbors, I don't hang out with them. You're just going to expose yourself to them, and then they're going to spread all your information around and use it against you." And you feel sad because it seems like projection. He feels like that's what he would do, so he assumes other people would do that as well, when that's really just not the case. And then when he's so surprised at the negative news coverage of him being a voyeur that seems so predictable to us but was a shock to him, you get the sense that he's so delusional about how he sees the world, and obviously the irony of him getting so upset about the news viewing him in a certain way when he viewed other people without their consent for so many years. And then when he's talking to the camera people and he says, "I really feel a kinship with you guys that I don't feel with many other people," you get the sense that he's just always wanted to be a scientist or a journalist, someone important, but he's just an ordinary guy, and he was never going to get taken seriously by someone like Gay Talese. I thought it was very interesting how they seemed to connect him having this early sexual experience of spying on his aunt with his voyeurism for the rest of his life, and you get this idea that maybe early sexual experiences that you have can really color the sexuality that sticks with you for the rest of your life. And like I said, the documentary does a lot to humanize him. His wife bringing over this birthday cake and, you know, before he blows out the candles, pulling it away and being like, "Make a wish." And you see him really think and then decide and blow them out. And you just compare this just sad image to the reporter who's going on these late night shows, being called a legend. Everyone's laughing at his jokes. And it's just, you feel for this guy, even though maybe you shouldn't. So I thought this was a really well put together documentary, a lot of different factors and issues that it explored, and if you want an interesting watch, definitely give it a go.